In 2018, WordPress moved away from its longtime editor to one it dubbed Gutenberg. Unlike the editor of the past, WordPress users now use a modern drag-and-drop block editor to build and customize websites, publish content, and sell their services and products online. So whether you're a longtime user trying to make sense of the new editor, or you're brand new to WordPress, this guide will teach you the ropes. But before we get into that, here's a bit more about us. WebsiteSetup.org is a free online resource for learning web development, design, and WordPress. Our goal is to help beginners create their own websites, blogs, and online stores using the right tools and platforms. To learn more about our review policies and processes, be sure to click the link down in our description box or visit us over at WebsiteSetup.org. So, let's get started. So from 2003 until 2018, WordPress provided its users with a basic text editor. The classic WordPress editor was your typical what you see is what you get kind of editor. In other words, you typed your content into the open field, formatted it using the toolbar provided, and that's more or less what your text looked like on your website. It's a simple enough interface and one that many WordPress users grew accustomed to over the years, but it had its limitations. In 2018, WordPress set out to rectify those limitations by releasing the new WordPress editor, Gutenberg. The new WordPress editor is a drag and drop block editor. This means that content is no longer written in one main editor. Individual blocks are actually dropped into place to build out the content of a page. When each block is selected, it comes with a unique toolbar. This allows for a more streamlined and customized editing experience as you're only shown the editorial controls you need at that time. The Gutenberg editor has also made it much easier to add the kinds of content and layouts that would otherwise be too time-consuming or difficult for a WordPress beginner to do on their own. Basically, there's no guessing game anymore. What you create within the block editor is how it appears on your website. The fonts, styling, and layouts, they all match. So as far as which one is better, the classic editor or Gutenberg, you'll really have to decide on that for yourself. Although WordPress automatically comes installed with Gutenberg, users can install the classic editor plugin if they're not ready to move to the block editor quite yet. So for now, let's take a deeper dive into Gutenberg and give you a better idea of what to expect from the WordPress drag and drop editor. Start with the WordPress menu on the left side of the screen. If you want to create a new web page, hover over two pages and select Add New. And if you want to create a new blog post, hover over two posts and select Add New. With your new page or post created, give it a title in the Add Title block. Now, paragraphs generally comprise the bulk of the content that we put on a web page, which is why the first block Gutenberg gives you is always going to be a paragraph block. To customize the style of your paragraph, use the toolbar that appears just above it. With most Gutenberg blocks, you'll have the ability to change the alignment of the content inside the block, and you could also format the text with bold or italic or add a hyperlink. If you want to make your links open in a new browser window, just click the down arrow within the hyperlink bar. And when you're done making your changes, click the return arrow to save the link. If you click on the down arrow in the toolbar, you'll find some additional text stylization options, and the last button in the toolbar will reveal more block options, including hide block settings, duplicate, insert before, insert after, edit as HTML, add to reusable blocks, and remove block. To add a new block to your page, you have a number of options. You've already seen the insert before and insert after options in your blocks toolbar. So that's one way to do it. But if you click away from your existing block and hover over the top of it, you'll see a small plus sign appear. When you click that, it will reveal your blocks. Just click on the one that you want to get started. Another way to add a new block is by pressing the return key on your keyboard. This will immediately add a new paragraph block to the page. Once you've started creating blocks, you might decide that you're unhappy with the order in which they appear. Well, Gutenberg is a true drag and drop block editor. This means that you can move your blocks wherever you want them with ease. The first option is to use the move arrows on the left side of each block. But if you want to make a more drastic rearrangement of your blocks, you should probably use the drag and drop. Just hover over the block you want to move and grab a hold of the dots that appear in the middle. You'll see your cursor change to a hand when you do that. Just make sure that you see a dark line appear before you drop it down. Now, if you decide that you want to remove a block altogether, you have options there as well. You've already seen one of these already. It's inside of your block's additional options. Just click remove block and it will be deleted. You can always delete it in an old-fashioned way too. Just place your cursor inside the block and use your keyboard's delete button to remove it. Now, reusable blocks come in handy when you want to create an element that can be used site-wide, like a promotional block for your blog or a call to action. Rather than trying to recreate the block on the pages it needs to go on, open your block options and click Add to Reusable Blocks. Then give it a name. Once saved, you'll be able to retrieve it and use it the same way that you would any of Gutenberg's blocks. You'll find it in a new category called Reusable. So there are dozens of Gutenberg blocks available. That said, there are certain elements that everyone uses to create pages or posts within WordPress. So just start by learning the basics. You can use the paragraph block to add plain text to your page, the heading block to add a header to your page, the list block to add a bulleted or numbered list to the page. You can use the image block to add an image to your page, which you can upload through your hard drive or select one that already exists in your media library. You might use the video block. You can upload a video file, choose one from your library, or pull it in from a link. Use the button block to direct your visitors or readers to take action. This might direct them to schedule now, sign up, read more, etc. The media and text block can help you merge text and images. And you can place two different blocks, either of the same or differing type, beside one another by using the columns block. Also, most of the popular plugins used by WordPress users are Gutenberg compatible. In some cases, these plugins have created special blocks that show up in your editor. For example, if you're using a contact form plugin like WP Forms, you should find a corresponding block for it. WooCommerce, WordPress's e-commerce solution, has done the same. There are also Ultimate Gutenberg plugins that add a bunch of new blocks to your builder, like Ultimate Add-ons for Gutenberg. So now that you've got the block editor down, let's turn our attention to the document and block sidebar. When your cursor's in the title block or somewhere on the page where a block doesn't exist, the sidebar will point to the document settings. These allow you to control things like the status and appearance of the page. Here are the main ones that you need to know: status and visibility, permalink, featured image, categories, and tags. The last part of the editor you need to familiarize yourself with is the toolbar that sits along the top of it. This might look like nothing more than a place to store the preview and publish buttons, but there's actually so much more you can and should use the toolbar for. The first button in the toolbar is where you can access new blocks. The next two buttons allow you to undo or redo. For those of you wanting to create pages that are easy for your visitors to scan through, the info button or I button gives you an overview of your content. The next part of the toolbar, page structure, reveals each of the blocks you've used to create your page. You use these first three buttons, save settings, with every page or post you create. When the gear or settings icon is clicked, it hides or shows the Gutenberg sidebar. And the last button in the toolbar reveals additional options and tools. Use this if you want to personalize your Gutenberg workspace. Oh, and it's important to note that starting in 2022, the classic editor will no longer be available. So now is really the perfect time to figure out how you're going to make Gutenberg work for you. We hope this video helped you understand it a bit better, and we also have additional resources over on our website, websitesetup.org. If you have any questions, be sure to comment down below, and we will talk to you next time.